relationship really shatters you. Why does this happen? Because we have not experienced the stillness within us. My purpose is to instill the stillness that prevailed when Buddha spoke to Subhuti. This is the way we have to put it in the language. Once it happened, Buddha came to Avantapindika Park in Shravasti. There were 1250 monks. Subhuti was one of them. And the Diamond Sutra happened. Subhuti did not ask anything. Buddha did not speak. Yet still Anand narrates everything. And he begins, "Thus I have heard." He has not said that Buddha spoke this, no. He says, "Thus I have heard." And there is a reason in doing so. Buddha would have said something, but you would have heard something else. Buddha represents the highest peak of consciousness. The fruition of an individual's consciousness, the highest peak. And when you reach at that level, nothing can shatter you. But this is the ultimate process of flowering. But before that flower begins to blossom, many problems come along the path. Relationship always remains and is considered a problem because we have not learned the art of relating and our focus is on relationship. In the process of relating, what happens? The other becomes the mirror. Remember, in the process of relating, the other becomes a mirror. And when you stand in front of the mirror, what does mirror do to you? It helps to look at your own faults. But instead of that, we look at the fault of the others. And we accustomed use the phrase that it is because of the other person the relationship is in problem. The relationship has shattered. When you are relating to anyone, the other becomes a mirror. And when you stand up in front of the mirror, you see many faces, many angles of yourself. You feel horrified that, "Oh, I did not put up the makeup and I just went in front of the people. What did they think of me?" Mirror points out to your own mistakes. It happened during the time of Aurangzeb, that was coming to the end of this 16th century. Mirror was considered one of the most precious ornament because it was not easily available. It used to be imported from China. Aurangzeb's sister Zebunissa had a mirror, a very precious mirror. One day the Kanis, that is the word used in the Islamic tradition for the servant, the personal attendant. Personal attendant of Zebunissa was bringing the mirror and it slipped from her hand and fell, broke into pieces. She got frightened. Now she will have to bear severe punishment. When Zebunissa saw this, she burst into laughter and she said, "Now I do not have anything to point out what my mistakes, what my faults are in my presence, in my being. And she was the ugliest person, but very spiritual. And there is a story between Zebunissa and Salmat alayhi salam, a Sufi mystic whose shrine is on the steps of Jama Masjid. Always remember, relationship becomes difficult if you do not understand the nature of it. You are working in the office. Very often we hear that this person is very difficult to deal with, or that person, or my husband or wife or his spouse is difficult to deal with. Whenever you are relating to someone, you can make it as a quote and stick somewhere in your office or place where you can see it always, so that you always remember this. When you are relating to someone, the other becomes a mirror. And when you look into the mirror, it highlights your shortcomings. This is where, why Bhagavad Gita says, and then mind comes to play its role. So Bhagavad Gita says, mind is your enemy as well as your friend. If you look at the mirror and try to correct the shortcomings, it becomes your friend. If you lament and you do not do anything to correct your shortcomings, then it becomes your enemy. Mind continues to nag about the shortcomings, and mind does not accept it willingly. It is always considered as if the other who is the cause of it. This creates a problem. And the same happens to the other. You become the mirror. This is why relationship always remains a problem. Only through awareness one can accept the face as is reflected through the mirror of relationship. Remember, only through awareness one can accept the face as it reflects through the mirror of relationship. And my purpose is to instill that consciousness in you, that you can understand this, go beyond this and experience the same consciousness, the same stillness that prevailed at the time when Buddha spoke of many sutras, be it Diamond Sutra. It is most precious sutra, the sutras of emptiness. Nothing was said, nothing was heard, yet still the entire scripture happened. Whether it is Heart Sutra or anything, then one day the same relationship becomes a way of transcendence. If because of ignorance, because of lack of understanding, you have abandoned the relationship, through meditation go into that. Try to look at it in many angles. And in that process, one day you will transcend. And once you learn to transcend beyond one relationship, you can transcend beyond any situation that can come into your life. Whether you are interacting with your spouse, husband, wife, children, neighbor, employees, employers, anyone you are relating to, and you understand the other becomes a mirror, and in mirror I see my own faults, the other becomes a friend. He points out that you must work on this. I look at it, I must work on this. Why do I get angry when I am relating to this person? Or why do I feel fear? He also carries the same spark of divinity that I do. He comes from the same source that is Nur. It is because something I need to work within me. And no one wants to know one's real face. So the problem comes in of shifting the responsibility on the other. And we grow up with that. When as a child you are growing up, the child is trying to make few steps, falls down, looks anxiously towards the mother or father or someone and begins to cry. Mother comes running, picks up the child. The child is looking at the mother, what the mother is going to do. She says, "That is none of your fault, child. It is the ground, it is the table, it is the chair that I hurt you." And she, for the consolation of the child, slaps the floor or the table or child. The table or the chair. And the moment this happens, the child feels happy that I did not get hurt because of me. It is because of the chair that I get hurt. And this continues to grow as our tradition. Somewhere or the other, we have to break up with the traditions. We learn something from our parents and we continue to carry on those traditions. In the process of transformation, we have to make a break. Whenever someone does something wrong, the father or the mother punishes the child. We learn that. And then we continue to do the same thing to our children. Somewhere or the other, there has to be a pause. No, this was the past. I have to, from here ushers a new era, period of renaissance. It happens many times. I have experienced those moments where I reached the threshold either to continue the tradition of the parents or go beyond that. There was a sort of conflict which is natural between the in-laws, my parents and the wife. Now what do you do? You cannot do the punishment to your parents or to your wife because they are strong enough. So you take it out on the children. The moment it happened, I was at the threshold. No, this has to break. I cannot carry on this tradition if I have to continue in the process of transformation of human consciousness. I must break this. This is how my parents lived. But no, from here it is a period of renaissance. I have to usher a new era. No, understand this. Anger begins to come and you do not know how to overcome this. Either start punishing the other, and only one who is weaker you can punish him. If someone is stronger, you cannot do that. So then you start punishing yourself. Then you cannot go forward. Indeed, nobody wants to know his real face. That is why down the centuries people have been escaping from relationship to the monastery. These are cowards. They are avoiding relationship. They are avoiding the way to relate and feel very happy. Because in a relationship, their true faces are reflected. Alone, they can think of themselves whatsoever they want to think. Outside the relationship, they can create an image they want about themselves, that I am a great spiritual master. But when it comes to relate, all that shatters. So the first problem with relationship is that relationship reflects you and you reflect the other person as well. And your totality comes up. You are not just what you project onto the surface. You may be looking very calm, composed and collected, and deep down you are a volcano, ready to explode every moment, and this is what happens in our day-to-day life. In fact, the volcano within is waiting for any small opportunity to explode. When the problem comes in, it is over always trivial matters. When you look around in your life, this is what you will find going on. So you prefer to opt out of the situation and then live like a Robinson Crusoe, and you can go on boasting. The deeper you get involved in your relationship, the deeper feelings will begin to surface. The relationship connects you to your unconscious, subconscious, and collective unconscious and subconscious. This is like this. You have your own unconscious. You have your own subconscious. When you are going to do a demonstration, you have a company of the others. Then your subconscious becomes a mob mentality. When people are demonstrating, they will engage in things which they will not do on their own. Look at the mob. Mob goes and loots, thieves things, that is the world. But on your own you will not do that. But if everyone in the mob is doing, then you will do it. This is collective unconsciousness. You do not want to drink, but you get the company of a friend. He says, have it. Have it. Have a dose. Have a drink. You have one drink. In the company, you do it. And then this word, have it, becomes your habit. You inculcate that habit. So I do not like this word habit. When someone says habit, I immediately remember that sooner this is going to be a habit, and I do not want to form any habit. So individual consciousness, when it is connected, added to the consciousness of the subconscious or unconsciousness of the other, it becomes collective. That is the dark aspect of your being. The very secret of relationship requires you getting connected to these layers, and through awareness transcend beyond these layers. Otherwise, existence will keep on creating situations again and again for you. Existence never wants to leave anything incomplete. And in fact, nobody wants to leave anything incomplete, but because when we feel incapable of handling this, we leave it and continue to feel that it is because of the other that I had this problem and I had to leave. You will again be pushed into the similar situation, and this process will continue until one day you girdle up yourself and decide, I have to go beyond these obstacles. The very secret of relationship requires you getting connected to these layers, and true awareness transcend beyond these layers. That's why I keep on emphasizing on meditating on the past happenings meditatively. Go into all sides of it and then transcend. If you are really into a relationship, it will shatter you. All your images will be shattered. All your faces will be torn. All your masks will start dropping. And whenever this happens, the person starts to take the revenge on the other. That is why your wife or the girlfriend goes on saying no. Behind her no, there is a deep yes. In fact, she wants to say yes. That is why she is saying no. But she is afraid of her own totality. Not only afraid of her totality, she is absolutely uncertain as well. And life goes on dragging like this for some time. Each expects the other to improve according to one's expectations, and nothing happens. Then one day after a brawl, you are finally out of the relationship. People have cleared a little ground of their being and they try to live comfortably there. The whole is like a vast canvas. They do not even want to remember. And whenever you are in love, your deepest feeling is stirred. Love indeed stirs your deepest core through feelings. With that feeling, all other feelings are stirred up as well. The whole ocean begins to come up onto the surface. Love is almost like the backdrop to the feeling body or the emotional body. It is, if your backbone is taken out, you will be spineless like a blob. Your spine holds you together. Exactly in the same way, the feeling body is held together by the spine of love. If you are not in love, you can control your anger very easily. In fact, if you are not in love at all, there will not be any opportunity to be angry. You can control your sadness very easily too, if you are not in love. You can manage your relationship very conveniently. That is possible when you opt out of relationship. And certainly this is what happens in monasteries. Your so-called saints are ordinary people who have come to know one thing about them. If they love, all chaos comes into being. If they do not, the whole chaos disappears. Indeed, it is the cheapest and easiest way to become peaceful. However, such peace is that of a graveyard. And I do not teach because this peace is the peace of the death. Indeed, I teach you living, singing and dancing peace. A peace that shines, dance, blossoms like a flower. Sways to the rustling wind. I would like you to go to the deepest core of your being without worrying about the consequence. If you are worried about the consequence, you can talk to me. Pass through the chaos and turmoil with great courage and certitude, because every childbirth is painful, and my role is threefold. First, a master is a midwife, gives you a birth, helps you in the process of the childbirth, of your own birth, then nourishes and nurtures you during the age of infancy, mothers you, and then finally he disappears. He gives you the taste of death, because that is the ultimate flowering. You dissolve as you are, the mind dissolves, the emotions, the feelings, you have experienced it and then it is dissolved. Only then you can attain to that kind of stillness that is insignia of Buddha, of the awakened ones. And the silence, the stillness that prevailed on Avant Pindika Park near Shravasti when Buddha spoke to Subhuti, or when he spoke to Mahakashyap, when one day Buddha appeared with a flower in his hand. With a flower in his hand, he looked at everyone. Now, when someone stands with a flower and you are expecting the person to begin this sermon, he says nothing, just stands or sits down with a flower in his hand. Many thoughts will begin to arise in your mind. Mahakashyap looked at that and he burst into laughter. And it is said, Buddha handed over that flower to Mahakashyap and said, I have spoken all that could be spoken, yet truth cannot be spoken. It is unheard, it is unspeakable, it is beyond all that is known. With this flower I hand over all that which cannot be spoken to Mahakashyap. When he came to Buddha, he was a great scholar, a scholar of his time. And he happened to meet Buddha on the bank of the river. He asked Buddha questions about existence. Buddha told him, if you ask him, if you have to cross over to the river and reach to the other side, how do you reach there? Mahakashyap was wise, but this question was very simple. He said, there are certain ways. The first is the way that you can, if you realize that the river is shallow, you can walk through the river and reach to the other shore. Second, if the river is deep, you can, and you know swimming, then you can swim through to reach the other shore. And the third, if you neither know swimming and the river is deep, you can take the help of a log or boat to reach to the other shore. Buddha said, if the person does not want to do any of these things, instead stand on this shore and continue to chant his do his rituals, continue to do his prayers, read his scriptures, can you reach to the other side? Mahakashyap had no answer. He simply bowed down to Buddha. He got the message that he was searching for, which he could not find in the scriptures. And he became Buddha's disciple, monk. And that day, when on Avant Pindika Park near Shravasti, Buddha appeared with a flower in his hand. He looked at everyone. Everyone said something or the other, or even if they did not say, looking at their mind, there was a process of thought going on in everyone's mind. Buddha handed over. When he looked at Mahakashyap, there was a total emptiness. And when the mind becomes empty, then something begins to happen. Then something can be poured into it. Which Ghalib says, Dil ka kalb ho jana, ki the biological heart becomes a spiritual heart. The spiritual heart is born in place of the spiritual heart is born, which is kalb, in place of the ordinary biological heart. Buddha handed over that flower to Mahakashyap, and that was beginning of Zen meditation, Zen way of technique. the meditation, the way to reflect, to enter into your being, and the process to transcend. Before whatever you do, all that is preparation. Pass through the chaos and turmoil and transcend it. You can meditatively go into the past relationships, past situations that you had found were difficult to encounter at that moment. When you meditatively look into, there is no possibility of getting hurt again because that is no more existing. But you can learn the process of transcending beyond it. And then you will not need to escape from any situation. Escaping is not going to really change you. Nothing will change then. You will have to pass through those situations in togetherness, with awareness. Only then you can attain to the state of transcendence. Then you can understand the secret and the essence of relationship. And in the world we have come here to go through all these situations. It is a great learning place where we have to come to learn. We have come to act through various stages that we have put into. Look at an actor when he is given a role. A script is written already. He is given a role. He has two aspects. One, the character that he is playing on the stage in the movie, and one that he is the real self. If he commits according to the situation of the script, an act, who is responsible for it? Is the character or the person? He is engaging in that act of maybe a rape as to fulfill the role of the character that he is fulfilling. Who is responsible for this action? The character or the person in reality? This is the most complex aspect of the theory of karma or actions. Most complex. Is the character that the actor is playing in the movie according to the script is going to, but that is a fictitious character that cannot undergo any punishment. Wherever you go and look for that person, you will never find that person in existence. And the person you will find, really, he has not done anything. He was simply acting. This is the complexity of action. I have given you, thrown a stone in the stillness of your mind to look into. You had been taught in a particular way, as is the action, so will be the reaction. No. It is a very complex and deep aspect of human existence. Then how does it happen? It is very simple to understand. You are the director, you are the person who is organizing a great function at your place. Distribute the responsibility on many people. The time is approaching and you realize that this particular part of the work is still lacking some work. And by the time the guest begins to arrive, this aspect will not be done. So what do? You take the responsibility from that person who was initially given to someone else. And this is the deepest aspect of karma. You have given the part of the responsibility to the other who you think is more capable. In the same way, when you are born, based on your skyograph, that what you will attain to the state, what kind of flower you will blossom into, the existence gives you additional responsibilities which ordinary human beings cannot undertake. Masters, Sheikh, the enlightened one, the awakened, are given extra responsibility so that the process of the transformation of the human consciousness becomes easy. What is very easy, with a flick of finger I can clear that situation, you may not be able to do. With a flick of finger I can overcome that situation, and you will take years and years, and yet still the pain will continue in you. But through that association, you will learn in a few sessions to overcome that. That's why a greater responsibility is given to the awakened ones, to help in the process of transformation of others. And this is where, according to the individual capabilities, the responsibilities are shared. And sometimes the awakened ones, when they realize on their own, they begin to take a greater share of responsibility, because no relationship can shatter me. No circumstance or situation can shatter me or an awakened one. Then it is very easy. In the company of that, it begins to happen as if you have not done anything, and yet still it has happened. And that is what the association is, that is what tawajjuh is, that is what the energy field of the Sheikh or the Master is. And that is how the entire process continues.